In this video, I'll be introducing you to the portfolio diet, which is a way of eating that has been shown to lower LDL cholesterol by close to 30% or almost as much as taking a statin. Hi, I'm Chong, a qualified nutritionist with a master's in nutritional sciences, here to share with you the latest evidence-based findings on healthy eating and living. In a previous video, I talked about how I lowered my LDL levels by almost 25% in less than 6 months, as well as one of the types of food that I incorporated to achieve that. The foods that I discussed in that video were actually one of the four components of the portfolio diet. In this video, I'll be walking through the evidence supporting how the portfolio diet was shown to lower LDL cholesterol as effectively as a statin, the other three components of the portfolio diet, as well as how you can incorporate these dietary components into your daily eating routine. In 2003, Dr. David Jenkins, the developer of the portfolio diet, and his colleagues ran a randomised controlled trial that pitted the portfolio diet against a first-generation statin. In the one-month study, participants were split into three groups. The first group was asked to follow a low-saturated fat control diet. The second group followed the same diet, but was also given 20 mg per day of a statin. And the third group followed a portfolio diet. Except for fresh fruits and vegetables, all foods consumed were sent weekly to the participants. Even though the study ran for only 1 month, participants in the control group reduced their LDL cholesterol by 8%, the participants on statins lowered their LDL cholesterol by 30.9%, and the participants on the portfolio diet reduced their LDL cholesterol by 28.6%, almost as much as those participants on statins. Since all the food was provided in the study, the compliance with the diets in all three groups was very high at around 95%. To see how the portfolio diet might perform under less tightly controlled conditions, the researchers ran another randomised controlled trial in 2011. While the 2003 study ran for only 1 month with 46 participants, the 2011 study ran for 6 months with 351 participants. In the 2011 study, food was not provided and participants were only guided by dietitians on what they were supposed to eat. At the end of the study, even though adherence to the portfolio diet dropped to around 46%, the reduction in LDL cholesterol was still an impressive 13.8%. What this study showed is something I always advocate, and that is healthy eating and living does not need to be all or nothing. And the 2003 and 2011 studies together showed that as long as you are able to implement some parts of the portfolio diet, you will achieve some lowering of LDL cholesterol. And the more you can implement, the greater will be the effect. Before I describe the components of this impressive portfolio diet, if you are enjoying this video, do hit the subscribe and the like buttons. That would really be the best way to support this channel, as well as help others find this video. Share in the comments also whether you have heard of the portfolio diet, or what other diets have you come across that have been shown to help reduce LDL cholesterol. You could also check out this other video where I describe how I lowered my LDL cholesterol, as well as details on the fourth component of the portfolio diet. Number one in the portfolio diet is plant sterols. Plant sterols are the plant equivalents of cholesterol. Don't be scared off by the drawings, but just by looking at the lines drawn, can you spot the difference between the structure of cholesterol on the left and the structure of the plant sterol on the right? It's this little extension on the upper right side of the plant sterol. As you can see from the structures, cholesterol and plant sterols are actually same, but not exactly the same. So how does that small difference in plant sterols help us reduce our LDL cholesterol? Because plant sterols look so similar to cholesterol, they can actually get absorbed in our intestines. What this means is that instead of absorbing cholesterol, the body absorbs plant sterols instead, and more cholesterol is excreted in our stool. However, what's fascinating is that our body still recognizes that small difference in the upper right corner on the plant sterol and will throw the plant sterol back into our intestines to be excreted. This 2014 meta-analysis of 124 studies showed that the higher the plant sterol intake, the larger the LDL cholesterol reductions. And achievable amounts of 0.6 grams of plant sterols per day from natural foods could reduce LDL cholesterol by close to 6%. What are some foods that are naturally high in plant sterols? These would include legumes like soybeans, green peas, lentils, and edamame. Nuts such as pistachios, cashews, and almonds, as well as vegetables like broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and cauliflower. Number two in the portfolio diet is nuts. Nuts is an interesting food that packs a big punch in a small package. They are high in fiber, protein, and healthy unsaturated fats, as well as other vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants. In fact, as mentioned, nuts are also one of the foods rich in plant sterols. So, how do these little champions help to reduce LDL cholesterol? Their effects seem to be multifold. Nuts contain some soluble fiber as well as plant sterols that can both reduce cholesterol absorption, and their healthy fats have also been shown to increase the liver's ability to remove LDL cholesterol from our circulation. This paper analyzed 25 different studies and found that eating 67 grams of nuts per day lowered LDL cholesterol levels by 10 points or 7.4%. What's also important is that the data showed that the effect was dose-dependent, meaning that the more nuts were eaten, the greater was the LDL-lowering effect. Even at 35 grams of nuts per day, which is about a big handful of nuts, LDL cholesterol could be lowered by 6 points or 4.2%. Number 3, and the heavy hitter of the portfolio diet, is soy foods. Plant sterols and nuts may not be common ingredients, but soy foods are definitely major players in Asian cooking, including all the usual suspects of soy milk, tofu, and edamame. Soy has played an important role in Asian nutrition because of a few unique properties. Soy is extremely high in protein compared to other legumes. It is a complete protein, unlike most other plant sources, and soy protein is almost as easily absorbed by the body as animal protein. Soy protein has been shown to reduce LDL cholesterol, and various experiments are suggesting that this could also be due to specific soy proteins increasing the liver's ability to remove LDL cholesterol from our circulation. This meta-analysis of 35 studies showed that an average intake of 30 grams per day of soy protein resulted in a reduction in LDL cholesterol of about 5 points or 3%. What was interesting was when the analysis was performed on studies that used only natural soy foods, such as soybeans, soy milk, and soybean oil, the reduction in LDL cholesterol doubled to 11 points or 6%. Again, as I generally advocate, less processed versions of foods will generally confer greater health benefits. Before I share how you could implement all of this in your daily routines, if you enjoyed this video, do hit the like and subscribe buttons. That would really be the best way to support this channel in making more content like this. Feel free to ask questions in the comments and share some ideas on how tofu can be included in your meals. Also, do note that if you have high LDL levels, do consult a medical doctor to discuss some medical options as you implement these dietary changes at the same time. First of all, a reminder again that healthy eating does not need to be all or nothing. As we saw earlier in this video, implementing any part of the portfolio diet will be useful compared to nothing. Of the three components mentioned in this video, soy is probably the easiest component to include in your meals. If you look out for high-protein tofu at the supermarket, half a pack of tofu for lunch or dinner and one glass of soy milk in the morning can already get you to 25 grams of soy protein or 56% of the amount prescribed in a 2,000-calorie portfolio diet. Nuts is probably the next easiest to achieve. Just grab a big handful of nuts, such as almonds, cashews, or walnuts, and have them as a snack in between lunch and dinner. A big handful of nuts will be around 30 grams, and that will be 67% of the portfolio diet. Plant sterols, on the other hand, are harder to include unless you eat fortified foods or take a supplement. However, if you can include into your daily routine 30 grams of nuts, one serving each of green peas, kidney beans, broccoli, and cauliflower, as well as 1 tablespoon of canola oil, which you can use to stir fry the vegetables or tofu, and 1 tablespoon of sesame oil, which you can drizzle over any of the cooked food, you would be up to about 0.6 grams of natural plant sterols, or 30% of the portfolio diet. If you average the three components, you can see that it is quite possible to achieve at least 50% of what the portfolio diet requires of these three components and potentially reduce your LDL cholesterol by 10 to 15%. If you enjoyed this video, you might also want to click on this other video where I go into the details of the fourth component of the portfolio diet, or check out this other video where I talk about other health benefits of a few of these portfolio diet components. See you next time.